time in the Lord. Also, I want to mention that Wendy is getting the young folks together this next
Friday,
May 12th, at the First Assembly of God. They're going to have a guest speaker from Joy FM. Okay, and you're free to come and be who you are and act as crazy as possible. Amen. This meeting is for youth of all ages, aimed more for the age group of 14 to 35 than this meeting. If older or younger, you are more than welcome to come and enjoy. There's some flyers on the back table. And another thing I want to do here with Wendy, you know what? I believe in giving people their flowers while they're living.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
If I move to heaven before y'all, don't bring me no flowers. If y'all got something to say to me or encourage me in some kind of way, do it now.
Yeah.
Okay, and I want to just give a bouquet of flowers to Wendy because of all the work she's doing with our young people. But I'm so happy to see them and Josh and Ashley and Wendy, all you doing, baby. A bouquet of flowers to you. Amen. Amen. Because you know the rest of us are, you know, we're aging a little bit. You know, most of us are barely out of our doors. And we need these children to come in and take over. Amen. The young people, not the children, the young people.
The next generation.
Amen. Glory be to God. Let me read. I like to share an encouraging word with you every week if I can. And this here is talking about great faith. Matthew 8, 9, and 10. This is the centurion replying to Jesus Christ. He says, "For I am a man under authority, having soldiers under me. And I said to this man, go, and he goeth, and to another, come, and he cometh, and to my servant, do this, and he doeth it." When Jesus heard it, he marveled and said to them that followed, "Verily I say unto you, I have not found so great a faith, no, not in Israel." Now there were two things in all the Bible that caused Jesus to marvel. There were the centurion's faith and the Jews' unbelief. A faith that made Jesus, who is the author and finisher of our faith, marvel is worth examining. This centurion believed that the spoken word of Jesus was sufficient to produce his miracle. You know, Jesus was so cool.
Yeah.
When somebody came to Jesus about something, he didn't have to go and fast and pray right there. He said, "I want it." You know, he had a power and authority, and he knew it. Amen?
Yeah.
When I lay hands on people, they shall recover.
Yeah.
That's what the word says. But it ain't about me. Woo! The centurion believed that the spoken word of Jesus was sufficient to produce his miracle. He didn't need Jesus to come to his house. He had faith in Jesus' word. Therefore, we can see that the person who simply believes the written word of God is operating in a much higher form of faith than those who require additional proof. Compare this centurion's faith with the little faith of Thomas. Thomas needed some additional proof. Thomas refused to believe that what he couldn't see or feel. Our five senses were given to us by God, and they're necessary for us to function in this life. But if we do not renew our minds to acknowledge the limits of our senses, they will keep us from believing.
Amen.
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 You know, like, I don't believe it until I see it. Well, you won't see it until you believe it. Amen.
Amen.
Faith can perceive things that the senses cannot. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. The type of faith that Thomas operated in was a human, a natural faith that was based on what he could see. Jesus said there was a greater blessing to be obtained. That greater blessing comes from using a supernatural God kind of faith that is based on God's word. In other words, if God said it, that settles it. We used to say, "If God said it and I believe it, that settles it." Well, it don't matter whether you believe it or not. If God said it, that settles it. Amen?
Amen.
Jesus and God's word are one. Believing God's word is not just putting your trust and some printed words on the pages of a book we call the Bible. There is much more involved. It is a relationship with a person. Amen. It ain't about religion. It's about relationship. And we get to know God through His Word. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Glory be to God. Amen.
Amen.
Have your Bible, I want you to hold your Bible up.
Thank you, Lord.
My Bible.
Say, this is my Bible.
This is my Bible.
I can do what my Bible says I can do.
I have what my Bible says that I have.
I have who my Bible says I have. And I am what my Bible says I am.
I am who my Bible says that I am.
And I am who my Bible says that I am.
And that is
a blood bought.
A blood bought.
Holy Ghost filled.
Tongue talking.
Devil stomping.
Bible toting.
Just quote. Child of the Most High God.
I'm blessed and I know it.
That's not my ego talking.
That's my faith talking.
I'm blessed and I know it. I'm not bragging on me. I'm bragging on God.
I'm blessed.
Heaven's bad.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.